This was very good news for Daniel, but very bad news for the wise men. You see, each one of them wanted to be second in command. Now that Daniel got the job, the wise men would have to do whatever he said. This made the wise men very unhappy, and they immediately started thinking of ways to get rid of Daniel.
Oh no, what we gonna do? The king likes Daniel more than me and you. Oh no, what we gonna do? We gotta get him out of here. Oh no, what we gonna do? The king likes Daniel more than me and you. Oh no, what we gonna do? We gotta get him out of here.
We could throw him in the dungeon. We could let him rot in jail. We could drag him to the ocean. Have him eaten by a whale.
We could throw him in the tigers, let him float a while. Then we'll all sit back and watch him eat a hungry crocodile. Put him on a camel's back and send him off to Ur with a cowboy hat without a brim, a boot without a spur. Oh, we could give him jelly donuts, take him all away, or we could fill his ears with cheese balls and his nostrils with sorbet. We could use him as a footstool or a table to play Scrabble on, then tie him up and beat him up and throw him out of Babylon.
Or...
I like it.
It's sneaky.
And it just
might
work.
With Pinchy!
We could use him as a footstool or a table to play Scrabble on, then tie him up and beat him up and throw him.